Good morning. Welcome to the lecture session on discrete probability distribution. Probability function: if P of xi is greater or equals to 0 and summation P of xi is 1, then the function is called probability function. That is, for various values of x, if we take p of xi should be greater or equals to 0 for any value of x, and also together if you take the sum of all this probability, it should be giving 1, not more than that. Discrete probability distribution: if xi is a discrete random variable and the set of values xi, p of xi is called finite probability distribution. P of x is called the probability density function, or PDF, or probability mass function, or PMF, where x is discrete random variable. The function f of x is given by P of x less than or equals to x, which is sigma I is equals to 1 to x P of xi, where x being integer is called cumulative distribution function. Mean, variance and standard deviation. Here there is no need to derive, only we need to apply the formula. That is, mean is mu is sigma xi into p of xi. Variance v is sigma xi minus mu the whole square into p of xi, or sigma xi square p of xi minus sigma xi p xi the whole square. Any one of the formula can be used. Next is the standard deviation, that is sigma is root of the variance. Let's see an example now. Find mean, variance and standard deviation of the probability distribution given by the following table. Here xi gives 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and p of xi gives 0.2, 0.35, 0.25, 0.15 and 0.05. Solution: mean formula is given by xi into p of xi. So, expansion of the summation gives x1 p of x1 plus x2 into p of x2 plus etc. x5 p of x5, which gives 1 into 0.2 plus 2 into 0.35 plus 3 into 0.25 plus 4 into 0.15 and plus 5 into 0.05. This gives on simplification 2.5. Next, let's calculate what is the variance. Variance formula is given by summation xi minus mu whole square into p of xi. So, xi means various values of 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. we have to substitute, and mu is already calculated. It's given by 2.5. So, x1 minus mu the whole square into p of x1 plus x2 minus mu whole square into p of x2, etc. The last value is x5 minus mu the whole square into p of x5. Substituting gamma value of mu, x1, p of x1, etc., we get on simplification variance is given by 1.25. Now, coming to the standard deviation, the standard deviation is very simple. Once we calculate the variance, its root is nothing but the standard deviation. So, variance value is 1.25, whose root is the standard deviation, that is 1.1 118. Let's see the second example. The probability distribution of a finite random variable x is given by the following table. Xi gives minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3. And P of xi is 0.1, k, 0.2, 2k, 0.3, and k. Find the value of k, mean, variance. And the second question is, find p when x is less than 1, p when x is varying between minus 1 to 2, when x is greater than minus 1. So this has to be found. In order to find the second question, first of all, we need to have the values of k so that the summation of p of xi should be equals to 1. Solution. We know that p of x is greater than 0 and p of x summation is equals to 1. So what we will do is we will add all the p of x values, that is 0.1 plus k plus 0.2 plus 2k plus 0.3 plus k is equals to 1. That is 4k plus 0.6 will give you 1. But 4k will be 1 minus 0.6, that is 0.4, and k will be 1. And mean is calculated, that is mean is equals to 0.4 plus 4k, that will give you 0.8, whereas the variance is given by V is equal to summation x minus mu the whole square into P of x, that is x1 minus mu whole square P of x1, etc. On substituting all these values, we get V as 2.16. Next, let's calculate the various cases. P of x less than 1 is equal to P of minus 1 plus P of minus 2 plus P of 0. That gives 0.1 plus k plus 0.2, that is equals to 0.4 on substituting the value of k. Now P varying between minus 1 and 2, we get P of 0 plus P of 1 plus P of 2, which gives 0.7. P of x greater than minus 1, which gives P of 0, 1, 2 and 3, that is 0.2 plus 2k plus 0.3 plus k, which gives on simplification and substitution 0.8. Thank you.